The video is Lila Nishmas, which Mubach and Chaim Tzedek. Today is a special day, very much for the Lubavitcher community, Achinu, the Bnei Lubavitch, and really everyone in Klal Yisrael, because as everyone knows, if you travel anywhere, you owe tremendous hakaras hatov to the Lubavitcher Rebbe, who sent the Shluchim all over the world. And we really even wish tremendous bracha and siyata d'shmaya to the Lubavitcher Shluchim, especially in China. They should be protected. The Lubavitcher Rebbe, I was zeichet actually to get $3. I have a personal hakaras hatov with three special brachas that I got from him. Unfortunately, one of them, they were all in Yiddish, so I only understood part of what he said. No video, as far as I know, from that day, 1990. But in any case, Lubavitcher Rebbe, of course, had a tremendous influence. And is, so we have a tremendous hakaras hatov to him. And his father-in-law, it's your side today. And when we speak about, I was speaking the two halachas a day, so I said very short, it's important to understand the concept of not saying tachnon and a tzaddik's yurtzeit. If you look in the Piskei Tshuvas and Kuf Lamed Aleph, which is a really written by somewhat of a Hasidic Talmud Chacham, who's writing things up Yalach, but also brings Hasidus, he quotes an amazing statement from the Bavich, from the Baal Shem Tov, just to get a little bit things in perspective. When it comes to a yurtzeit of a tzaddik, so really, if you look in halacha, there's no source at all for not saying tachnun. If anything, the Kafah Chaim and others bring down, and even great tzaddikim, Hasidic rebbes, like the Nemuke Chaim, the Munkacha, and many others, everybody, they would scream when one would not say tachnun. So where did this really come from? Not to say, I mean, you go to any shul today, when you hear the knock on the bima, and there's no tachnun today because of the yurtzeit of so-and-so, so where does that come from? So it actually comes from a Rashi in Maseches Yevamos that says actually that the day of a yurtzeit used to be a time where Talmidim, the students, would gather, and they would call it actually a yirega. It would be a very special holiday. Now really, if we go to the closest sources, Lubshim Bayichai, we all know Lag BaOmer, we all celebrate it. Now there's a major difference really in that regard, because Avshim Vaicha, when he died, so he revealed tremendous Torah. So it was actually a day, what's called the Yom Hilula, a day of a wedding. It was a very special day. Usually when a tzaddik dies, it's a sad day. And therefore, the more a person mourns and supplicates, the better. However, if one wants to follow the halacha, to my humble opinion, this is the way that it's brought down also from one of the, it's in Minhag Yisrael Torah, and it's also quoted here in the Piskei Tshuvas, it's kedai to see. I want to tell you two things. Number one, the power of saying Tachnun. Listen to the words from the Baal Shem Tov. So he quotes a pasuk. It's actually a pasuk that we're not so familiar with. It says Ve'es Ma'acha. It's one of the names that are mentioned. Things in Pashas Vayera. Ma'acha. It's the name of a lady. So the Rosh HaTevis, the Baal Shem Tov, Ve'es Ma'acha. He says is Vidui Acha HaTfila. When one says supplications, vidui, and confession after tefila, magas at kisei hakavod, it reaches the throne. So this is from the Baal Shem Tov, the so to speak, the king of Hasidus, the source. And if he's saying that how powerful nefila sapayim is, how powerful vidui is after davening, of course one would give all the money not to be able to say it. So where does the skipping, where does the not saying come from? So the not saying, as I pointed out, comes from this Rashi, and really in the much more Hasidic Minhagim. But the main concept was that if a person was connected to this tzaddik, so for example, if someone was very connected to the Lubavitcher Rebbe's father-in-law and studies his firm, or for example, on the yurtzeit of the Baal HaTanya. In fact, the Hasidim, the Tzaddikim say, and very much the Satmar Rebbe, and many, there were three specific yurtzeit that they didn't say. One of them was the Melchim Lezhinsk. These are Sfarim, these are Tzaddikim that people study. So since they've gained so much from them, that already gives much more credence to not saying Tachnun. That's where it comes from. So I will tell you the following. Lehalacha, whenever you are in a... So whenever a person has a question, should they say Tachnun or not? In general, 100% yes, unless it's quoted in Shulchan Aruch Natu, of course, in days of holidays. However, if a person's in a shul where there's a minig and it's a bona fide minig, so there is what to rely on, especially bona fide means that this tzaddik is someone that people really were nurtured and are nurturing from. If that is not true, and it's just a little bit of chaos, and they're just not saying tachanun because they were not taught and not studied properly what the halacha is. So then one should quietly say tachanun or should say tachanun after davening. Never ever make a machlokes. Have an amazing day.